to get us started. France will be running left to right. As we said, they're yet to concede any points against Japan so far this season. 78-0 on aggregate against the Japanese. And that's gone over the head immediately of the Japan catcher. But they've done well to maintain possession. And they'll try and launch their first attack of the HSBC Singapore Sevens. That passes loose over the top and almost an opportunity there for Trouabal. There is Trouabal. He has the ball to Perez now. And here's Pasquet, Varian Pasquet to Nisi Oyad. He's got the tape around his head. And the legend, the veteran, Jonathan Logel, in his 74th event for France here in Singapore this weekend. Perez and Riva in midfield. Here's Sefo, so dangerous. 20 tries in 5 events in his fledgling World Rugby Sevens career. Beautiful conditions here in Singapore and a beautiful start for France. Breaking through the middle and a cheeky offload out the back from Pasquet to Riva. Vavavoom from Le Bleu, early doors in Singapore.
Well, that was the turnover by the Japanese. It gave this potent French side a chance. Riva is going to add the extras here. Captain's try there, great backing up from him. Seven-point automatic interpretations on him. But look, there's the big handoff from Pasquet. He was probably good to go himself. Look at the awareness, changing the ball to the correct arm, and then knew he had support, just laid it up into space. Riva won't get an easier one this weekend.
Yeah, Pauline Riva from the Ouch Club, but Pasquet from Stade Francais in Paris. And Stéphane Perez, who's been a full-time sevens player for many, many a year, gets us restarted. His 57th event for France. So much experience in this French team. And
knock on. Oh.
So much inexperience in the Japanese side. More debutants on deck for them this weekend. They're missing some of their key players and an error for them in their own 22.
Yeah, as you said, 4 debutants. So the nerves are there. This is a big stage. It's humid here, but that one's inexcusable. Just takes a while to get the sevens cohesion together. And as we mentioned off the top, the Japanese are a little bit disrupted. Ideally would be in here all week preparing in the conditions in Singapore. And they came in late.
There's confirmation of that stat. Yet to concede a point, still applies. Here's Reaver again. Already a try. He's got a double within 3 minutes in the Singapore sevens opener.
Well, Perez loves it, smiles. Japan have conceded 100 tries in the 4 events this year, and tackling like that is why they're averaging 25 tries an event. A good fend, but just not great body position, a little bit tentative, and great strength from Riva. Not a bad start for the captain, Soiru.
Yeah, not bad. Yeah, he thought about going around the post, didn't he, to try and get a bit closer for Perez. He's got a difficult kick from out wide, just can't nail that one. So it will remain 12-0. Still 3:30 to go in this first half. But had a chat on the phone to Simon Amor, who's of course the new head of performance for this Japanese team, their technical director. He couldn't make the trip here to Singapore this weekend, but he'll no doubt be watching on in the wee hours back in the UK, trying to get this Japan sevens program back to the sort of form that got them back as a coronation on the Sevens World Series.
Yeah, I know he's very excited about the potential here, but they've just got to put some things together. They have the talent, and they've got, you can see the team list, they've embraced by the professional clubs a little bit more support from that great league in Japan. And they've chosen, after the faulty kickoff from the Frenchman straight into touch, they've chosen a midfield scrum. So a great opportunity, lots of space to work with for the Japanese attack.
So set piece here for Japan right on the halfway line. Can they make something of this opportunity? Hideki Yamada out of Keio University will feed the scrum. Nice switch of play and a nice breakaway. And look at that for Japan. They are running clear and they have their first try in Singapore. And that's an absolute belter for Japan. And they certainly showed it there off the set piece. They've had 9 weeks to prepare for this tournament, like all the sides, a mini pre-season, if you like, within the series. And it looks like they've been doing some good stuff on the training field there.
Yeah, they are one of the top offloading teams, the Japanese. And interesting, they got their reward there for some very direct running off a set piece, off the midfield scrum. Fortunately, backed it up with a kick straight into touch. Now France on the attack.
Perez just shows and then bursts through a gap. He'll be taken to the floor by Morita. Trubal at scrum half to Logel. Pasquet again, he set up a score for his captain a little earlier. There he is, Riva, his Sefo. Big, powerful, rangy runner. Look at him go. Jordan Sefo has his first try in Singapore.
Well, we talked about the potency. Three of these players in the top 10 try scoring on the series. This was in the end. Look at that. He drops the shoulder just enough, and then he almost moonwalks it into the end zone. Sefo. I don't think that's the last time we'll see him crossing the whitewash this weekend.
No, that's number 21 this season. He is right up there. Terry Kennedy, the Irishman, leading try scorer on the series. Sefo right in behind. He's been a great addition. Conversion attempt from out wide, doesn't make it. 17-7. Clock's in the red, but try was scored before, so we will have a restart before we break for drinks. Very humid today here in Singapore. We've had all sorts of weather this week. We had massive thunderstorms on Thursday. It cleared up yesterday. It was piping hot earlier in the week, and the humidity's really racked up again this weekend. So tough conditions for the players.
Yeah, we do have a covered roof here in the Singapore National Stadium. The ends are open and the air conditioning's on, which is a nice one, but I don't know how much difference it's going to make on the pitch.
Yeah, I'm still feeling it, Rusey, got to say. It's still pretty warm. Here comes Japan again, already one try in this game. Here's Taiga Ishida. Good tackle on him from Perez. Going in to help out is Yuki Ishii, one of the co-captains. And there was Tominaga at scrum half. Little kick through. The tactics really working well for Japan so far. It sits up beautifully. Nakagawa, he is brought down in the red zone. Picks up, goes again. Expertly done, offloads. But that's just gone forward. And we will go to half time. But yet again, Japan finding a way to open the French door.
Well, look at this. It was a beautiful nudge through, and everyone in the stadium is waiting to see what kind of bounce is he going to get. It pops up to him. Look at this. Nicely, but he just doesn't have the legs as he had to break stride. And in the end, the forward pass will kill the movement, and it'll kill the half.
Yeah, good tackle from Pasquet. France go to halftime. 17-7 over Japan. Well, well, well. As we said, they were scoreless against France on the series ahead of this match, Japan, but they've scored one absolute cracker and almost followed it up. And there's for the French in the opening half, but an absolute cracker from Moeki Fukushi, which was converted. Keeps it at 17-7 with 7 minutes to go. Sefo, who did score a try for France in that first half, takes the restart. Here's Logel, most experienced France 7 player of all time. Trubal. He was lively in the first half. Joachim Trubal, originally out of Racing 92, high tackle, arm over the shoulder, zero tolerance for that.
Yeah, just the high contact. Again, two Japanese defenders going in. They're not completing these one-on-one tackles, and that's really stretching them as they set up their defensive wall. Perez always cool on the ball, just telling everyone what he thinks. Here goes a set-piece move from the French.
Yeah, Perez, he's hunting his 80th all-time try on the series. Here's Trubal again. Riva working hard to secure possession. Still with the same seven out there, France. The start of the game, quick hands to Sefo. That was nicely done from Varian Pasquet. He does like to offload the ball. Sefo gets away from the tackle, and Jordan Sefo has two for France. He is devastating. Not much space required for this guy.
Well, 6'4", 104 kgs, just too big, too strong. And he's got the pace to finish it as well.
He's now only 8 tries away from setting a new French record for most tries in a single season. The man who holds that record, the great Julien Candelon, who's now involved with the French Rugby Union. We saw him out in Spain with the women's team. Former top 14 winner with Perpignan, absolute legend of the game. A broadcaster as well, as Perez bangs over a couple, but you get the feeling that it's not long till Seffo breaks Julien's record.
I would think so, and great that French rugby's got that kind of support. Of course, this year we've got the World Cup of Sevens, but also the Olympics looming for Paris for 2023.
Logel, brilliant, off the restart, and the inside ball to Pauline Riva. If you're gonna score a hat-trick, well, why not do it that way? Logel to Riva.
Individual skills, so important. Just timed that run impeccably, and then had the awareness to keep that ball alive, get the right arm free, and always Johnny on the spot, Pauline Riva.
Follow good people, that's what they say. And Pauline Riva certainly did that. Logel, brilliance off the restart. He's a real veteran of this side, and Perez has his kicking boots on now, and this second half is going exactly the way that France wants it. And there is the all-time try-scoring chance for France, the great Terry Brahua, little Terry the general, top of the charts.
Well, young Albaladejo there as well, one of the great names of French rugby. He's overcooked that kick, Perez.
Yeah, fifth overall, three cup quarterfinals, their best finish, fourth in the second leg in Dubai. They're the only team inside the top five on the series standings without a medal this season. So they're going to be desperate to try and change that here. Either this week in Singapore or next week in your place, Vancouver.
Number 5 and 11.
Yeah, not happy hunting grounds for them. They haven't been to a cup quarterfinal here in Singapore since 2016. But that does show you the dominance they've had. They've had their hands on the ball a lot. And they're incredibly efficient in the red zones, too. 21 of 22 visits they scored on in Sevilla. Similar stats coming out of this game, I'd have to guess, Rupert.
Bind! Set! Hold.
Still just over 3 minutes to go. 31-7 to France in the Pool D opener. Coming up next, we've got Ireland against Fiji. Here comes Japan. Can they add to their scoreline? Cracking try in the first half to Fukushi.
Advantage, high tackle.
Good attacking opportunity. Yeah, high tackle again is the call. Heard the clear instructions from the referee. Ishida running slightly across field, and here's Latianara with the burst and the offload and taking on his Morita. And there's another excellent high quality try from Japan. They're not done yet. Chikara, Morita.
Well, that's the energy they play with. We'll look to add the extra two here. Looking for a bit of a miracle. Keeping his hands free, getting away from the tackle. And then look at the backup, the support here, the desire to get on the ball. He's hit that hard, and he's hit a great line. Fooling that French defense, getting Japan second.
He's 32 years of age. Correction, 38 years of age, Latianara, and he's still doing that sort of stuff. I mean, it's extraordinary. He's the oldest player in the squad by 9 years.
Hope he has someone to hang out with on the road.
William Iraguha is out there, as is Grand Didier, so they've emptied the bench. France looking to get something going. How's that for a burst from Nelson Epe?
Go back here.
He is a dangerous player. The
high tackle.
The boy from Toulouse. We're going to be in Toulouse in May.
Time off.
The France Sevens are shifted from Paris down there into French rugby heartland at the Stade Ernest Vallon. Going to be a marvelous tournament, men and women.
Yeah, one of the great rugby cities of the world. Stade Toulousain will be dying to host. To say both the men and the women. How about the women's game just taking off? So much to play for this year.
Nope.
He's going to get a rest, eh?
Yeah, he deserves it. He's got his triple, got a hat-trick. That's the way to start your HSBC Singapore Sevens. Rayan Rebaj big burly fellow from Toulon. His big brother plays for Toulon and for France in 15-a-side rugby. Logel. Extraordinary engine.
Still going.
6'4" veteran. Yeah, look at him going. There's the offload nicely done to Mazzolini. And he'll get clear. And he'll run clear. Another score for France. The bench players have taken the field. And they have kept the momentum going. Thibaut Mazzolini.
Well, always nice. But look at the big man spinning. You talked about his experience at 29 years young. Just constantly keeping himself in the game, keeping that ball alive. And as you said, fresh off the bench, Mazzolini gets his reward. Speaking to him this morning in the elevator, very concerned about the humidity. Didn't seem quite happy there, crossing for his first of the weekend.
Yeah, and Logel with his second assist after the brilliant restart take for Riva. Now one for Mazzolini. Iraguha. He's taken over the kicking duties from Perez. There's the gong for full time, but we'll have a restart of play. Clocks in the red. Iraguha kicks to the far side. Latianara is there to bring it down. He flings it over to Morita, try scorer. Makisi with the carry.
It's got to be said, Rupert, there's been some positive moments for Japan. Perhaps their defense needs a bit of work. They've turned that ball over as they arrive at the ruck. So a few things to go forward on as they progress in this pool D. Of course, Ireland and Fiji still to come.
Number three. Time off. Number three. You? Three.
I think this may be for rolling the ball away after the penalty.
Yeah, they're really tough on this in sevens. They like to keep pace on the game. They don't want any opportunity deprived from the team that's been awarded the penalty. So zero tolerance for that.
France are still going to have a go. Of course, points difference could come into it. I mentioned Ireland and Fiji in this group. You never know at the end of day one.
Yeah, if three teams are equal on pool points at the end of the three games, it comes down to points difference between those three sides. So France looking to finish, but they're over the sideline on the far side.
Is it ball in touch? Ball in touch. That's gone dead.
And that will be that in the Singapore Sevens opener. And it's been a fine beginning for France. Japan had glimpses of their try-scoring ability, a couple of scores for them, but, well, the fifth seed's far too good. 36-14 in Pool D.